Hey, I'm Abbi Jacobson.
And I'm Nat Faxon. And we're about to recap part one of Disenchantment for all of you.
Once upon a time, there was a princess named Bean. She's amazing, unlike any princess you've ever met. And her family, her dad, King Zog, her lizard stepmother, Queen Una, and half-brother, Prince Derek, ruled over the kingdom of Dreamland. Bean's real mom died when she was just a toddler, and the only memory she has of her is a statue. You'll want to remember that for later. Bean is being forced to marry a prince from another kingdom, Prince Giesbert, so Dreamland, and namely King Zog, can become more powerful. But I was like, no way, that's stupid. I want to live on my own rules and be happy, right? I mean, Bean said that, not me. I'm Abbi, not Bean.
Meanwhile, in a land full of candy-making, uncontrollably happy elves, one elf named Elfo is absolutely miserable. And let me tell you, Elfo's cute, but the dude gets around. He has this girlfriend, and let's just say they stay busy. So anyway, Elfo is sick of having to be happy all the time. And he's like, I'm getting out of here. I'm going to live by my own rules and be miserable. Elfo also has this adorable voice. And he's like, I'd rather die a big death than live a small life.
Back in Dreamland, Bean is preparing for her forced wedding. She's looking at her pile of wedding gifts, and this little box is calling to her. She opens it, and it's this little demon with a smart mouth. This demon, Lucy, was sent by these two culty-looking people in robes who look over Bean and want her to turn evil to fulfill a destiny. So Lucy's now Bean's awesome new personal demon who gets her to do bad things like get crazy drunk and some other stuff that we'll get into later. So it's Bean's wedding day, and she's at the altar with this doofy guy, Prince Giesbert, and when she's asked if she takes his hand in marriage, I yell out, no! I mean, Bean says no, not me. Why do I keep doing this? She knocks the ring to the ground and the ring goes rolling off. Prince Giesbert runs after it and impales himself in his head onto a sword and dies.
So amidst all the chaos, Elfo crashes the wedding and everybody is like, whoa, because they've never seen an elf before. Everyone goes crazy, especially King Zog, because he heard that elf blood holds the key to the elixir of life.
Bean, Elfo, and Lucy get the hell out of there. The royal guard chases them through the kingdom and into the enchanted forest, and then the trio jumps off a cliff. They survive and are captured and dragged back to the castle so Bean can marry Giesbert's brother, Prince Merkimer. In a series of mishaps, they turn Merkimer into a pig, and Bean is free.
Now, Bean can go on to live her crazy life with her new friends, Elfo and Lucy. They get drunk, they experiment with snake root, they join a gang, they kind of start a band where they just clap. Elfo boxes a rooster for some reason. There's a party with a horse, a one-eyed giant woman who Elfo claims is his girlfriend, an exorcism that was super fun. Mm-hmm. Look, they get into some crazy shit, is what I'm trying to say.
Okay, back to business. Remember how King Zog is looking for the elixir of life? They find out that they need to find this vial called the Eternity Pendant that they're supposed to drop elf's blood into to unlock its powers. They go on this big journey, meet this old guy and his laughing horse in a cave and a griffin. They end up killing this guy who performed the exorcism, and they eventually find the vial and bring it back to Dreamland.
They try Elfo's blood in the Eternity Pendant, but it doesn't work. And they're like, whoa, so Elfo is not a real elf? So that opens up a whole can of worms, and Elfo is now on the pursuit to find out who he really is. So Bean, Elfo, and Lucy travel back to Elfwood, where Elfo finds out that he's only half elf.
Whoa.
When he's about to find out what the other half is, Dreamland soldiers invade Elfwood to capture all their elves for their magic blood, and it's absolute mayhem.
All right. So I'm gonna pause right here and tell you we're getting into some major spoiler territory. So I'll wait a couple seconds for you to make a decision on whether or not you want to continue watching this.
How was your summer so far?
My summer's been pretty good. How about you?
Pretty good, yeah.
Okay, here we go. In the midst of battle, Elfo is shot by an arrow and dies. And it turns out King Zog ordered the raid on Elfwood so he could get pure elf blood, not so he can live forever. Remember that statue of Bean's mom? The Eternity Pendant has the power to bring her back to life. Bean brings Elfo's body back to Dreamland to give him a proper funeral, and she finds a little elf blood that hit her during the battle. And now she has the power to bring someone back to life. She chooses her mom, guys.
Yeah, it's really messed up.
It's extremely messed up.
Because Elfo died.
We need to be able to separate us and them.
Seems like you are already having a problem with that.
Bean's mom, Dagmar, is brought back to life and begins ruling the kingdom again with King Zog after getting Una out of her way. So coincidentally, after Dagmar is unfrozen, people in Dreamland are being turned into stone. Everyone thinks it's Una, but no. It's freaking Dagmar. Lucy, being the genius that he is, discovers that years ago, Dagmar tried to poison King Zog and turn him into stone so she can rule the kingdom. But cute baby Bean switches their wine glasses and Dagmar gets hoisted by her own petard, if you will.
I will.
So now she's back and trying to turn all of Dreamland into stone. She's crazy, but she convinces Bean she's innocent and convinces her to leave the kingdom to fulfill some mysterious destiny.
Okay, you're caught up now. Enjoy Disenchantment Part 2.